Cheap beer has long been associated with the aluminum can. Upscale brews are bottled, but some craft brewers are trying to break that stereotype. A number of Columbus small craft breweries have switched from glass bottles to cans. It's canning day at Four String Brewing Company in Grandview. On this day, the seasonal brew, Vanilla Porter, will go into about 7,500 cans, or 1,250 six-packs. That repetitive rustling sound is several dozen empty cans inching toward the processing line. The cans are sprayed with some sanitizer before they're filled with beer. Then they're capped and sealed off. The Vanilla Porter is the fourth Four String beer to make it to the canning line. Owner Dan Cochran says he decided to start canning just 6 months ago.
It's booming. It's flying off the shelves, and we have not been able to keep up since the first month we started.
One reason is cans help beer taste better longer. Craft beers are known for their bold aromas and flavors, and they're more expensive than the average domestic beer. So brewers want to keep the beer tasting fresh as long as possible. Cochran says aluminum cans do better than bottles.
Cans don't allow in any light.
UV light can make beer taste skunky, and Cochran says cans grant a longer shelf life.
The can or the end is said to seal much better than a crown or a bottle cap does, so there's less oxygen getting to the beer.
Brian O'Reilly is the brewmaster at Sly Fox Brewing Company in Pottstown, Pennsylvania. Sly Fox has been a leader in craft brewing this side of the Mississippi River. It was the first craft brewery on the East Coast to can beer back in 2006.
I think early on, people that didn't like craft beers in cans wouldn't talk to us. They wouldn't give us the opportunity. But I think now it's become so commonplace that, you know, people have had more and more good experiences.
Aside from some specialty brews, Sly Fox cans all of its beers. Why? O'Reilly says cans are environmentally friendly, they get cold faster, and they're space savers.
They're easier to ship, they're lighter, and you can pack more in a small space. And obviously, you know, when we're talking truckloads of beer, it can save quite a bit of money.
Russ Phillips operates craftcans.com, a website that tracks craft beer. In cans, of course. Phillips says canning craft beer, no longer a trend in his opinion, can be budget-friendly for new small breweries.
I definitely think it's a cost thing. That's one of the first things I think a small brewery would look at, would be cost. And getting their beer in cans, especially using a mobile canning outfit, it's a good cost cutter there. You don't have to invest in your own canning line, especially if you don't have a lot of space and money. That's a good deal.
Four String and Seventh Son Brewing in Italian Village both use a mobile canning service, which shows up with all the equipment and cans they need. Colin Castor is a partner at Seventh Son.
We chose to just do those two because when you're canning initially, it's a pretty big investment. You have to actually buy literally a truckload of each can. So we start off with two, and we're going to add some more in the future, but we thought it'd be a good way to start.
And to the naysayers who refuse to drink beer from a can,
I'm a big fan of pouring everything that I drink into a proper glass so you can get a little bit of aroma from it. I think that if you do that with a can and did a blind taste test, that you'd never be able to tell the difference.
But Phillips admits not all canned beer is good beer.
There's good beer in a can, there's bad beer in a can, and the canning process itself, there's a lot of variables there. So the best beer in a can is the beer that's A, brewed very well, but also canned very well.
Sure, cans may be cheaper and better for the environment, but there's something else about the can.
They're cool.
They look cool.
Four String's Dan Cochran agrees.
I love the looks of cans. To look at our six packs and be able to see graphics all around the package itself, I just love it. I think it looks great.
According to Phillips, craftcans.com, there are more than 500 craft breweries canning more than 2,000 types of beer in the U.S. Mandy Trimble, WOSU News.